Stephen, did you notice that old friend David Cornwell has been named the starter at Nevada? They opened the season against Northwestern. So if you didn't hear that, I think if Mark Rogers TV goes the Nevada football route, I can probably bring you out as an analyst and knowing David Cornwell as well as you do.
I actually did read news on that yesterday, and congratulations to David Cornwell, a fine young man. This is somebody that was an Elite 11 participant coming out of high school, somebody that was one of the nation's top pro-style quarterbacks. I think he was high. He was actually number 57, if I'm stating this correctly, number 57 in the ESPN 300 when he was being recruited, came into Alabama in 2014 out of Norman North High School in Norman, Oklahoma. The last time he played meaningful snaps was his senior year at Norman North. He had a knee injury, which limited the second half of his season, did not play much at all his senior year. As a junior, he passed for over 2,000 yards. He rushed for 755 yards and had 33 touchdowns total. But the thing about him, he's got size at 6'5", 228 pounds. And what's going to be good for him at Nevada, as head coach Jay Norvell talked about it, he wants his quarterbacks to be accurate on those short to intermediate throws, the short to intermediate passing game. In Nevada, a fast-paced offense is quick. Your 1-2-3-step drop, getting the ball out and allowing your playmakers to do the work for you. And that's something that Cornwell actually excels in. He has a big arm, but though he hasn't really fine-tuned the deep ball accuracy, the short to intermediate range game, he is actually golden at. And during his spring game for the Nevada Wolfpack, passed for 302 yards with two touchdowns. Coach Norvell very impressed with his short to intermediate passing game and has named a Cornwell the starter as of right now. Will he hold on to that job going into the first week of the football season remains to be seen. But as of right now, Norvell very much so impressed with the accuracy on the short to intermediate routes that David Cornwell does exude. He was an individual that for a moment at Alabama kind of had his hand on the starting job or was in the battle for that starting job when Alabama had Jake Coker in, Blake Barnett as a freshman, of course, Cooper Bateman, and David Cornwell was rehabbing well from that knee. He was getting healthier. He was getting stronger. So was in the competition during the 2014 season, 2015 season. Also, during that 2014 run, Alabama had Blake Sims in the fold. 2015, more so the Coker, Cooper Bateman, David Cornwell, Blake Barnett time. But didn't pan out as well as David Cornwell would have planned it to. However, did earn his degree, graduated early from the University of Alabama, does have three Southeastern Conference championship rings, was a part of a national championship team in 2015. So did get a chance to earn the hardware, see what it was like to play under head coach Nick Saban and achieve that type of success while learning the system, learning the playbook and being a part of the culture. And now he has a chance to kind of write his own script as a starter or potential starter and be a part of a team that he can guide to having a 10-win season for the first time since 2010. The last time Nevada had a 10-win season, the 2010 year in which it went 13-1. So Jaden Norvell has a quarterback in David Cornwell on his hands that can do some special things.
And if anybody's lost track of Cooper Bateman, he is with the Utah Utes under Kyle Whittingham. Marcus Williams is one of the more experienced returning starters in the Pac-12, so Bateman probably won't start, but they've left the competition somewhat wide open for him. Utah, traditionally a pound and ground type attack there under Whittingham, but really going to open it up this year and going to a new offensive coordinator and new offensive scheme. So it may fit well for Cooper Bateman to possibly play and vie for the starting position in 2018.